Hello friends, so today we are going to check out how we can integrate MQTT service with a .NET application. integrating MQTT service with a .NET application is a very simple thing. So you may be having this requirement if you are dealing with IoT projects and those kind of things actually. So I will just show you how we can integrate MQTT service with a .NET application. So I have created a sample project in which two different Windows applications are there. One is application 1 and another one is application 2. So both are having same kind of design. I will just run the application and I will show you how we can integrate the MQTT service. So fine. Now we are running the application. Okay. So you can see there are two different applications. One is application 1 and another one is application 2. Now, what we are going to do is we are sending a MQTT message from application 1. So I'm just typing, this is a sample MQTT message from application 1. And I'm clicking on the button named publish MQTT message. So now you can see once I click the publish button, instantly the message got displayed in the application 2. So application 2 is receiving the message and it got displayed inside application 2. Now here I am typing another message. So I'm just copying it from application 1. And pasting it here. Now instead of application 1, I'm using application 2. Yeah. So now I'm clicking. Now I'm clicking publish MQTT message button, and you can see instantly application 1 has received the message and it got displayed here. Now whatever message what we have given. So for example, I'm just typing hello world and clicking on publish. It got instantly received by application 2 and it is displayed here. And in application 2, I am just typing hello world from application 2 and clicking on publish MQTT message. Yeah, it got displayed here. Okay, fine. So the application is working fine. And now I am just explaining how these things will work. So just I'm closing these two applications and going to our Visual Studio. Okay. Now we are taking application 1. And inside that we can see a form 1. Okay, so this is the design what we have made. One text box here, one button here, and another list box here to display the messages received. Now I am going to the code. So just before that, what we have to do is in both projects we have to use a library. So in if we click right mouse on reference, we can see an option named manage NuGet packages. So we can install NuGet packages. So I have already installed M2 MQTT, that is a very popular library for integrating MQTT service. Okay, and also in application 2 I have used the same NuGet package library named M2MQTT. So you can use this library for integrating MQTT service. Now I am going to the code line by line. I'll explain you each lines. So first of all, this is the form load function. So when the form loads, this particular function will get executed. So here what I have done. So here you can see I have declared a private variable that is MQTT client. And here I am initiating the variable. MQTT client is equal to new MQTT client. And here I have given the IP address. So here you can use the server IP or wherever you have installed the MQTT service. You have to install the MQTT service in any of the machine, in server or in a machine or wherever it is. The only thing is the machine in which MQTT server is installed should be reachable from the application, should be reachable from the machine in which applications are installed. Okay, now I have installed the service in the same machine. So I have used this particular IP 127.0.0.1. Now the next thing or next command what I have given is MQTT message publish received, means when this particular machine received an MQTT message, so then what has to happen? I have already defined it as a function here. So you can see I'm just reading the message from the MQTT event. So you can see here I have used encoding dot utf8.getString e.message. So this e.message is basically coming as a byte array. So we have to convert it to a string. So for that, I have used this particular command. And once I got the message, I'm just displaying it in the list box. So for that, I have used an invoke method. Why? Because this is a background method. So this particular method will be running in a different thread apart from the UI thread. So from a background method, if we need to initiate the UI thread, we have to use invoke. Okay. So here I have given list box 1.items.add message. Message is the message what we got from the MQTT. Okay. Now the next command what I have used is subscribing for a particular MQTT topic. So this is a very important thing. So here this is application one. So what I have used is when we are getting a message in this particular topic, topic is like an address. So this particular application will listen for a message coming in this particular topic. Okay. And we are having a different kind of MQTT QoS level. QoS means quality of service. I'm not going in detail regarding this QoS levels, that you can find it in MQTT documentation. So there are different kinds of QoS levels. I will just show you. QoS level at least once, QoS level at most once, QoS level exactly once, QoS level guaranteed failure, granted failure. So, okay, currently here I am using QoS level at least once. But you can go through the MQTT documentation and you can find out the difference between these all QoS levels. And you have to use the appropriate QoS levels what you need. Okay, so now the next thing, we are going to connect the MQTT server. So the command is very simple, MQTT client.connect. And here we have to give a client ID. See, this is the client ID. So here, the only thing what we need to keep in mind is the client ID is a unique value. It should be unique. That means if one client connected with application one, the client ID is application one, then another application with same client ID cannot be connected. It should be unique. The second application would not be able to connect because the MQTT server will restrict, or it will throw an error when we connect with the same client ID. The client ID should be unique for each applications or for each clients. Okay, so here I have given application one. So this is application one. So I have just given the same name. What you can give whatever name you need or whatever value you need. The only thing is it should be unique. Okay. And if your MQTT is having some username or password, you can provide that username and password here. Like this. As I'm not having a username and password, I'm just removing these values from here and just connecting MQTT directly without username and password. Now, so we have gone through the commands what we have used in application one, and in application two, we have the same type of commands, but here what we are doing is, instead of listening for messages coming to application one, we are using application two here. I will just show you view code. Okay. Here you can see we have used application two as the client ID, and we are listening for a particular topic like application two slash message. So this particular MQTT client will be listening for application 2 slash message topic, and the QoS level is same. And here I have to tell you one more thing. We can subscribe for multiple topics. So if I need to subscribe for another topic, I can give it here itself, slash application 2 slash message 2. And also I need to mention the QoS level for that particular topic it also. So here I'm also mentioning at least once. So now the MQTT client will listen for two different topics. And for the first topic, it will be QoS at least once. And for second topic also, it will be QoS at least once. If I need to change topic, I can change it here. Okay, for the second topic, I can use exactly once. That is completely my preference, whatever it is. So anyway, now for this application, we only need one topic. So I have just used one single topic. Okay. Now coming to MQTT publish. So when the button is clicked, button means publish MQTT message. So from application one, if the button is clicked, first we are checking whether the MQTT client is connected. So this means it will check whether the MQTT client is connected to an MQTT server. So if it is connected, then the second command is to publish an MQTT message with topic application to MQTT message. So from application one, we are sending the message to this topic. So from to, we are sending message to application two message, two slash message. And the message content, we will get it from the text box dot text. So here we will get it as a string, and we are converting it into bytes actually. So for that particular reason, we have given it like this, encoding.udf8.getbytes of textbox.txt. In the same way, in the application 2, we are publishing a message to application 1 slash message. And in the same way, we are using encoding.udf8.getbytes and getting the string from textbox1.txt. So when someone is clicking this particular button, automatically the application will get the text from this particular text box and convert it into bytes, then publish the message to this particular topic, what we have given here. Okay, so whichever client which is listening for this particular topic can receive the message when we are publishing from here. So this is what happening. So now I will run the application again and just explain you how it works. So, okay, application 1 is here and application 2 is here. So from application 1, I am just sending a message by typing message 01. So now when I am clicking publish MQTT message, what will happen is from application 1, it will execute this particular command. So MQTT client.publish to this particular topic, and the message will be message 1, which I have typed in the text box. So when I'm clicking publish MQTT message, you can see the message has been received by application 2. Now in the same way, from application 2, I'm typing a message and publishing it, so it got received in application 1. So this is a very simple scenario or a very simple logic what we have to use in MQTT service. So if you are dealing with IoT devices or any other kind of similar kind of devices, you should have to use MQTT client for listening for a particular topic. So you can do it in this way. Okay, so that's it for today's video. See you soon. Thank you.